Welcome back. I'm KT, and that's KAY-T, and I'm an artist. World famous Oscar the Cat has been doing some new artwork lately, but I just like to bring that to your attention today. Just start out with talking about Oscar's most famous piece within the genre of postmodern cardboard deconstructionism. This movement has been within art since it was introduced by Oscar, and it's very important to find cats since there are such an underrepresentation of cats within art and pop culture today. But since humans already have trouble representing themselves as a whole, the fact that they have failed to represent all animals as well is a reflection of humans within themselves failing themselves. So just taking into account that Oscar is cat de facto, it's something that you can't take away from their work. But I'm already going really deep here. I don't want to get into that right now. If we just look at this piece, what I hear the artist saying is, what this work in particular is saying is, this box is not a box. This box's purpose has no purpose. I, Oscar, have rendered it into a purposeless state. But this raises a lot of questions for the audience. Is that to say that it had no purpose before and now it does not? Or it never had a purpose? Or it has a purpose that was never the purpose it had been intended to have? Perhaps I, Oscar, have given it purpose to which its former predestined purpose had been unfulfilled, as if I had negated that box's existential crisis in which it is so necessary for its being to have in order for it to discover that it is indeed a box, however, in which it had no sense of purpose until it was given to him by society, Oscar here representing society, or some other external force such as a deity. Am I, Oscar, the deity to this box's natural being? But are my actions active toward the box's fate or passive? I, Oscar, may not even be acting in concern for the box's being, but solely for my own pleasure. Is this a nihilistic commentary on what deity the world is named and unnamed throughout history? And or is this a critique of deity itself within human consciousness as well as cat consciousness? I myself am not cat, so I cannot speak for cats. So I'm really speaking from a very subjective filter, being indeed human. But to corner this piece into only discussing religion would be unfair. So to carry back, we have to take into account the obvious, what is in front of us now, what is happening in the performance aspect of the piece, which is very important, very easily overlooked, and the piece itself being so heavy. But what we see here is the cat is demonstrating the consciousness to which we have heretofore attributed only to humans as humans. So what does that imply for humans? And what does this imply about the underrepresentation of animals within a humanistic society? This piece is a deconstruction of this human privilege. So the box not only represents the literal box, its most physical form and physicality, but the box also represents humanistic society. And the performance of this piece, to separate it from the piece itself, is discussing what humanity means, what consciousness means, what human consciousness is. And it's a rebellion not only to religion, but also to human privilege and to the limitations within one's own existence and ability. It is self-reflective. It is personal. And I see a lot of frustration here. I see deliberation and I see an attention to detail disguised as a bystander who is probably not as trained in art as myself, would not grasp of the hidden meanings within the piece and the piece's performance. all the layers can be hidden from the untrained eye very easily. So that leads us back to the question of, does this piece actually carry meaning, or are we just retrospectively giving it meaning on the basis of its presentation as a piece of art? So saying that I'm applying a meaning that is more than the artist's intent is negating that claim to which the movement, the medium, is represented within, implying then, that is to say, the artist must have known that there would be claims against this intent of the piece being more than the artist's intent, and thus the artist has secured within the movement in which is presented what the medium, and that is the artwork itself, really intends to be. And now we've reached full circle, but it just doesn't get more art than that. So that's it about explaining and enlightening you about Oscar's work that has been exposed here in the videos by Paul Klusman. It's been a pleasure cooperating and coordinating with Paul and his cats. I look forward to critiquing more and exposing more of this artwork. It's been great working with animal artists as well. It's been a growing experience for me. So tune in next time for what I have to say about the universe of art next. So, radical.